morning, everyone. My name is Godwin Murunga, the Executive Secretary of CODESRIA. And I am happy to announce that CODESRIA is preparing for its 15th General Assembly, which is scheduled to take place between the 17th and 21st of December 2018 here in Dhaka at King Fahd Hotel. The General Assembly is a triennial activity that CODESRIA hosts. It's both a scientific but also a governance meeting where members of the community of social science and humanities researchers on the continent meet not just to discuss a scientific theme but also to make decisions about the governance of the council. The 15th General Assembly will be focusing on the theme Africa and the Crisis of Globalization. It's also going to be held on the back of a series of other things that have happened within the last 1 year in the Council. Perhaps the most important one of which is the passing on of Professor Samir Amin, who was the first Executive Secretary of CODESRIA. And perhaps the most important person who has influenced the trajectory of the Council over the period that he was alive. This is going to be the first General Assembly when Professor Samir Amin this is going to be the first General Assembly since the passing on of Professor Samir Amin, and perhaps the only General Assembly of CODESRIA where Professor Samir Amin will not be present. A number of developments that took place other than the passing on of Samir Amin. I would like to remember the late Professor Abdurraufu Mustafa, who was a key member of the community who passed on in 2017. Professor Aminata Diao, who was not just a key member of the community but also a former senior program officer at CODESRIA, who also passed on in 2017. At the General Assembly, we are also going to be celebrating the life and achievements of these colleagues of ours, and we are hoping that it would be an illuminating moment, not just for the African social science community, but actually the global social science community, because these were not just academics in Africa, they were global academics reflected on issues of global importance, and we think that the 15th General Assembly provides us with an opportunity to remember them and to celebrate them. The General Assembly will involve a number of activities that the Council would almost always hold. We are expecting that a number of important keynote speeches will be delivered at the General Assembly. There are confirmations to be had between today and when the General Assembly will be held. But I need to say that we have already consulted with His Excellency, former President of South Africa, Thabo Mbeki. We have also consulted with the Nobel Laureate, Wole Soyinka. We have invited Professor Osman Khan, who is a professor at Harvard University, and the Kenyan writer Yvonne Owuor. They have all indicated a willingness to join the Assembly but to also give the keynote speeches to the Assembly. We will be confirming with the community once the formal logistics have begun, but my own expectation, and indeed our own expectation at the Secretariat of CODESRIA, is that this would constitute key moments in the General Assembly. We will be beginning the General Assembly on the afternoon of the 17th, hopefully in the presence of senior government officials from the Senegalese government. We have extended invitation all the way to the presidency, and our hope is that they will have time on their schedule to join us. And we will conclude the assembly on the 21st of December with the election of the new executive committee of CODESRIA. And also perhaps a discussion of the way forward for the Council for the next 3 years. So this indeed is an auspicious moment for me as Executive Secretary. It is auspicious partly because it is the first General Assembly that I am organizing. I am happy to note that I have been accompanied by a team of extremely dedicated, hardworking colleagues in the Secretariat, many of whom have actually participated in organizing previous General Assemblies. It's therefore really my pleasure to be able to lead this team of colleagues in the Secretariat who have dedicated a lot of their time, who have gone beyond the call of duty to be able to make sure that the convening that we are preparing for will take place in a good way. I would like finally to make the point that we are looking forward to welcoming a diverse set of members of the social science and humanities community. We received a total of 768 abstracts at the start of this process. We did select slightly over 350 abstracts, a good many of which were developed into full papers. We eventually did receive slightly over 250 fully written papers that were subjected to a competitive peer review process. And we now have just slightly over 200 fully written papers. And we are convening all these academics from a diverse range of African countries, predictably with Nigeria, Cameroon, and the Democratic Republic of Congo having the highest number of selected papers. But close to over 20 countries will be represented at the General Assembly. So it really is shaping up into a Pan-African event, in the true sense of the word Pan-African. Not just that people will be represented from different countries, but the spirit of the General Assembly itself is a Pan-African spirit. It's a Pan-African spirit where we center the diversity of Africa, emphasize the importance of the Pan-African orientation of our council, but also be able to celebrate the fact that this Pan-Africanism is not defined racially. It is in fact an inclusive moment for us to re-emphasize, indeed revitalize and re-emphasize the importance of the African identity as an organizing identity of global significance. So I would like to welcome all those who have been selected to the General Assembly. I would like to invite you to continuously come back to this site where we will be giving you weekly updates on preparations, where we will also share aspects of the planning and where we should be able to answer any questions that you have that you would like to share with us. And we hope that you will have a safe trip to Senegal. You will feel welcome when you come to Senegal. We cannot emphasize enough that CODESRIA finds Dakar a good home. It finds the Senegalese people welcoming people. And we celebrate the fact that we are able to create a Pan-African home in Dakar, a home that we feel extremely comfortable about. So thank you very much, and again, welcome to the 15th General Assembly of CODESRIA.